Dear students, this particular class I want to discuss a few questions based on ellipse and hyperbola of basic model. Let's see the first question. He is saying length of the minor axis is equal to 16 and the coordinates of the foci 0, comma, plus or minus 6. Focus coordinates are given 0, comma, plus or minus 6 means definitely it is the second form of an ellipse. So he has given BE is equals to 6. Whenever second form of an ellipse, length of the minor axis is equals to 2A. So that's why 2A is equal to 16. From this we can say A value is equals to 8. But in the second form of an ellipse, what is the condition? The condition is given by A square is equals to B square into 1 minus E square. Now this simplification, 64 is equals to B square minus B square E square is equal to 36. So we are getting the value of B square is equals to 100. A square value is equal to 64. B square value is equals to 100. Therefore we can write the equation of an ellipse is X square by 64 plus Y square by 100 is equals to 1. So next question is saying B is equals to 3 and C is equals to 4. Center at origin foci on x axis, that is the information given. So generally if you observe the NCERT textbook, in the NCERT textbook focus they are giving as C comma 0. Focus they are giving C comma 0. So that's why origin, center at origin, foci is on x axis. According to our convenience, we are taking the focus as plus or minus AE comma 0 on x axis. That's why in the question the information C is given as a 4 means AE is equals to 4 given and the value of B is equal to 3. Whenever we are taking focus as AE comma 0, then what happens the condition? Because x-axis, focus is on x-axis means we can take the condition is B square is equal to A square into 1 minus E square. Therefore we are getting 9 is equals to A square minus A square E square. Therefore we are getting A square value is equals to 25 and B square value is equals to 9. Therefore the required ellipse equation is X square by 25 plus Y square by 9 is equals to 1. Right? So the next question is given as center at origin. We have to find out the equation of an ellipse. Center is at origin. Major axis is on Y axis. He is saying major axis is on Y axis and the ellipse is passing through the point 3, 2 and 1, 6. That is the information given. So X square divided by A square plus Y square divided by B square is equals to 1. That is the equation of an ellipse where A is less than B, because he is saying major axis as Y axis. That means foci lie on Y axis. So that is the reason A less than B taken. In the question he is saying that ellipse is passing through the point 3, 2 and 1, 6. When it is passing through 3, 2, what happens? 9 by A square plus 4 by B square is equals to 1. When it is passing through the point 1, 6, what happens? 1 by A square plus 6, 36 divided by B square is equals to 1. Now from this we can write 9 alpha plus 4 beta is equals to 1. And again we can write here alpha plus 36 beta is equals to 1. So these are the two simultaneous equations in terms of alpha and beta. I hope so you know how to solve these two equations. So from these two equations you can find out alpha value and beta value. That means alpha value we got means we got the value of 1 by A square. Beta value we got means we got the value of 1 by B square. So we are getting 1 by a square means a square value, 1 by b square means we are getting b square value. So we can find out the equation of ellipse. So next question is asking focus is given as plus or minus 4 comma 0, and the one more information is given as length of the lattice rectum is given as 12. Immediately, if you observe, he is asking to find the equation of hyperbola. If you observe this one, coordinates of the foci given as plus or minus 4 comma 0 means we can compare this one with foci plus or minus ae comma 0, and in the first case of hyperbola, length of the lattice rectum is equals to 2b square by a, that is equals to 12. So from these two relations, we have to find out the values of a and b. Once we got the values of a and b, we can find out the equation of hyperbola. So as ae is equals to 4, and here we have the information b square is equals to 6a. What we can write b square according to the ellipse first, hyperbola first condition, b square is equal to a square into e square minus 1 is equal to 6a. Therefore, we are getting a square e square minus a square is equal to 6a. In place of a square b square, we can write 16. That's why we are getting this equation as a square plus 6a minus 16 is equal to 0. Now factorization, you will get a plus 8 into a minus 2 is equals to 0. So from this we can say the value of a is equal to minus 8 and the value of a is equals to 2. But a is equals to minus 8 not possible. When a is equal to minus 8, b square is equal to minus 48, which is not possible. That's why a is equal to minus 8 not possible. The value of a is equals to 2. When a is equals to 2, you will get b square is equal to 12 and a square is equals to 4. Then the equation of hyperbola is x square by a square minus y square by b square is equals to 1. So this is the equation of hyperbola for that information. So one more question they have given like this. Vertices given plus or minus 7 comma 0. That means we have to compare vertices with plus or minus a comma 0. And eccentricity is given as 4 by 3. E is equal to 4 by 3. Then he is asking to find the equation of hyperbola. A is equals to 7. And E value is given as 4 by 3. So according to the first form of hyperbola, the condition is b square is equal to a square into e square minus 1. Directly we can get b square is equal to a square is 49 into e square. That is 16 by 9 minus 1. So we will get 49 into 7 divided by 9. So we got the value of a square and you got the value of b square. So we can find out the equation of hyperbola as x square by a square minus y square by 49 into 7 divided by 9. So this is the equation of hyperbola. So one more question. The question is given here. Focus given 0 comma plus or minus root 10. Focus is given as 0 comma plus or minus root 10. And the hyperbola is passing through the point 2 comma 3. With the focus 0 comma plus or minus root 10 and passing through the point 2 comma 3. Now we have to compare this one with 0 comma plus or minus BE. Therefore we are getting BE is equals to root 10. Therefore B square E square we can write it as 10. And hyperbola equation x square by A square minus y square by b square is equals to minus 1. Second form of an hyperbola, we have to take x square by a square minus y square by b square is equal to minus 1. The hyperbola is passing through the point 2 comma 3. So 4 by a square minus 9 by b square is equals to minus 1. Now it is in the second form. In the second form, what is the condition for hyperbola? A square is equal to b square e square minus b square. A square is equal to b square into e square minus 1. But here b square e square is equals to 10. That's why we are getting a square is equals to 10 minus b square. Right? So therefore 4 divided by, in here we can write 10 minus b square minus 9 by b square is equal to minus 1. I hope so. From this we can find out the value of b square. B square value substitute here, you will get a square. Then we can find out the equation of hyperbola. So this is the next question. The next question is given in this way. A man running a race course. A man running a race course, note that the sum of the distances from two flag posts is 18 meters. Find the equation of the post traced by the man. So the information is saying that a man running a race course, note that sum of the distances from two flag posts is 8. Find the equation of the post traced by the man. And also given the distance between the two flag posts is also given. So let us say here this is the position of the man. This is F1, flag post number 1 and flag post number 2. So this is sum of these two distances. Sum of these two distances is given as 8. So PF1 plus PF2 is equals to 8. Right? So PF1 plus PF2 is equals to 8 given, and also given the distance between two foci. The distance between two foci, 2AE, is equals to 12. That means F1, F2, distance is given as 12. Then he is asking to find the equation of an ellipse. We know this value is equals to 2A. The 2A value is equals to 8 means A is equals to 4 we will get. Distance between two foci also we know 2AE, that must be equal to 12. And 2AE is equals to 12. Then we will get here A value already we got 4. Let us take this one as not 12. This is equal to some 6. Okay, 2AE is equals to 6. But 2A value is equals to 4. Right? So 2A value is 8. Therefore we are getting 8E is equal to 6. Therefore E value is equal to 6 by 8, that is equals to 3 by 4. Now what is the condition? Because we have taken the information in the first case. That's why we can write B square is equal to A square into 1 minus E square in case of ellipse. So you know the value of A and you know the value of E. A value, E value substitute here. We will get the value of B square. Yes, enough. You got A square and B square. We can find out the path traced by the man. That is equation of an ellipse you will get. An arch is in the form of semi-ellipse. If it is 8 meters wide and 2 meters height at the center. So let us say this is the semi-ellipse. What is saying in the question? This center, at the center height is given as 2 meters. And this portion width is given as 8. That means this is 4 and this is also 4 meters. Find the height of the arch at a point 1.5 meter from one end. First of all, we know the equation of this ellipse. The equation of this ellipse is x square by 4 square plus y square divided by 2 square is equals to 1. That is the equation of an ellipse, because this is A value is 4, B value is equals to 2. He is asking from one end at a distance of 1.5 meters. Alright, this distance is 1.5 means what can you say about this distance? 2.5. If I am assuming this height is equals to h, this height is equals to h, then obviously this point becomes 2.5, h. And 2.5, h is a point on the ellipse. So substitute that point here, you will get 2.5 whole square divided by 16 plus h square divided by 4 is equals to 1. From this we can find out the value of h. So that is about another application type of problems from ellipse. So one more question, he is saying a rod of length 12 meters with its ends always touching coordinate axis. A rod of length 12 meters that is there in such a way always touches the coordinate axis, its ends. Determine the equation of locus of a point P on the rod which is 3 centimeters. This point locus we have to find out. Let us say that point is PX1Y1 which is at a distance of 3 meters from one end in contact with X axis. So this is the rod always ends on coordinate axis. This length is given as a 3. Obviously this length becomes 9 or not. Now I am assuming this is equals to A and this is equals to B. Then I can say this point as A comma 0 and 0 comma B. So what is the meaning? This total length is equals to 12. This part is 3 units means this part becomes 9 units. Now I can say this particular point divides the entire segment in the ratio 3 is to 9. That means this ratio is 1 is to 3. Now according to the section formula, what we can write? 3a plus 1 into 0 divided by 3 plus 1. Next, 3 into 0 plus 1 into b divided by 3 plus 1 is equals to x1 comma y1. And one more condition is there for us. From this right angle triangle I can write a square plus b square is equals to 12 square. Because this rod length is given as 12 meter. This is 3, this is 9. Total given as 12. A square plus b square is equals to 12. From this we can write 3a is equals to 4 times x1. So a is equal to 4x1 divided by 3. Whereas from here b by 4 is equals to y1. Therefore we are getting b is equals to 4 times y1. A value we got and b value also we got, substitute here. Therefore 16x square divided by 9 plus 16y square is equals to 144. So that simplification you will get the required equation of an ellipse, right? So these are the few applications on ellipse. Next class we are going to discuss more applications on ellipse. Okay, bye bye.